Eden. Here, brothers, I want to stand over a fa'ida, latifa, a benefit that we can take, which is that Allah told us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that this Qur'an is what? It is preserved. It is what? It is preserved. And that it's what? It is protected. And that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected it by making Nabi Muhammad memorize it all. And there's a i'jaz, a miracle in this, without a doubt. And the miracle is Rajul, which is Ummi, a man who can't read or write. Who is that? Nabi Muhammad. He can't read nor write. الَّذِينَ يَتَّبِعُونَ الرَّسُولَ النَّبِيَّ الْأُمِّي. That they follow the Prophet who's illiterate, couldn't read nor write. Allah says in another ayah, وَمَا كُنْتَ تَتْلُو مِنْ قَبْلِهِ مِنْ كِتَابٍ وَلَا تَخُطُّهُ بِيَمِينِكَ إِذَا لَرْتَابَ الْمُبْطِلُونَ. Muhammad, you are one who didn't write this Quran. You did not write this Quran. Nabiullah Muhammad, who could not read nor write, had memorized this whole Quran in his heart. He kept it. In its lengthiness, he's kept it, alayhi salatu wasalam. At an age where majority of people can't start memorizing at that time, 40, he memorized it all, alayhi salatu wasalam. This is khariqun lil ada. This is outside the norms. This shows us that it's a mu'jiza. And that he would lead them on this. Because wallahi, if the Quran was a lie, you can't remember a lie that you made up. And if it was a lie, then it would have to, if you want to remember the lie that you made up, you would have to write it somewhere to always go over it. But he can't do that because he can't read. Alayhi salatu wasalam. So the fact that he memorized these surahs in this length, and the ayat being mutashabih, looking like each other. Wallahu bima ta'amaluna basiran. Wallahu basirun bima ta'amaluna. Ayat that are back to front, remembering each one. The ones who can read and write are struggling to memorize it. Hadihi, this ikhwah, is enough to show a person that this Quran is a miracle.